Hi, I'm Dr. Sushal Shanthakumar. I'm a consultant shoulder surgeon practicing in Manipal Hospitals, Bangalore. The first myth, some people ask whether it is caused due to repetitive use of my shoulder. I do a lot of homework. Has that caused the frozen shoulder? In fact, it is the exact opposite of repetitive use. I would say it's probably something to do with underuse. Most of the time, when in case of some immobilization following an injury, or it could be due to some sort of inflammation in your shoulder or some sort of fracture in your forearm where the shoulder has been immobilized, that causes frozen shoulder. Second myth is, a lot of people, the conventional wisdom tell it is a self-limiting condition. People say there are around three stages. Classically, it begins with the freezing stage where the patient has a lot of pain, unable to move his shoulder. Then comes the frozen stage where pain is a little less, but the shoulder is frozen. Patient cannot reach behind the back, is not unable to lift his shoulder over his head. Then finally comes the stage of thawing, where people believe, you know, the movement slowly return. So I would like to say, you know, the evidence does not support this theories. There is no definitive evidence to say that the frozen shoulder almost always is self-limiting. So it's a biggest myth. So it has to be intervened at some period of time.